Take a look at this unsightly pile of garbage, which has accumulated in an area where tourists, especially those who arrive on the cruise ships at Point Serafin, stroll into town. Theotime George, who has been operating a business in the area, says this has been an ongoing problem, especially after mass crowd events like Carnival. He says he's forced to clean up most of the time since the garbage is left near his place of business. He is now at his wit's end. As a result, he's recommending that authorities have the vendors pay a deposit. He says the refunding of the money should depend on how well they clean up after mass crowd events.
So I'm appealing to the authorities that when these people come and vend, it happens every New Year's and every carnival, make sure that these people clean the area. And there are places I feel that they shouldn't even vend due to the area. Because if you see what they do to the grass is dark, one part is green, one pack is brown, and it's not looking healthy at all.
The state of the surroundings is certainly not in keeping with the St. Lucia Simply Beautiful logo on his place of business. And Theotime George says it certainly does not augur well for tourism.
We're complaining about things hard and all kind of things we're complaining about, but we are part of the problem. We say we are tourist destiny, keep St. Lucia clean. And when you go, people just littering all over the place. They're seeing signs. They see in bins that they refuse to do the thing in the perfect way. I'm trying to keep that little place as clean as I can because you have the cruise ship is just on the other side. You have PVT visitors going up and down. That is the main highway. And I'm trying my best.
Apparently, the problem of garbage disposal is not confined to the Sans Souci area. The St. Lucia Solid Waste Management Authority is also reporting complaints from communities about garbage not being collected on the designated days. The authority says under the contractual agreements, contractors are supposed to inform the organization of any challenges that prevent the collection on time.
And we issue notices when we find that in response to complaints, we've investigated and found that they haven't collected on time. We will issue a default notice and give them a deadline by which they have to collect. That's just to make sure that the garbage doesn't stay on the ground for too long because we know what can happen in that case. But, you know, it's up to the contractors then to make sure that their equipment is in order, they have the necessary stuff and they maintain the schedules.
The Solid Waste Management Authority says zonal officers have also been appointed to monitor the collection of garbage in a timely fashion and inform residents of any changes in the schedule. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.